Hey, what's up? John Sonmez here from SimpleProgrammer.com. And today we're going to be talking about shaking off a bad reputation. I've never had to do that. No. How do you shake off a bad reputation? This is good. This is a good question. I mean, we can take this a lot of different ways. This is from Aladdin. That's, talk about someone who has to shake off a bad reputation as a thief. Aladdin. So, okay, he says, "Hi John, thanks for a lot for your videos. I've carved out a niche on my team as the C++/tech pro with higher knowledge than average dev, but that came at the expense of some domain/application knowledge. After receiving criticism for that in a review, I've worked hard to change that and with good success, but I find the old rep sticks. I'd suggest the same idea as a colleague, but mine would be seen as too fancy or tricky almost instantly. Is it too late for me to fix this label?" It's never too late. You can always reinvent yourself, right? I mean, if you've seen go look at my old YouTube videos, okay? Look at this channel and look at some of my old YouTube videos and look at over the years. I've reinvented myself many times, okay? As I've grown, as you personally grow. And some of you that have come into this channel from recently, you've only known me as this John. You haven't known me as the Clark Kent John of yesteryear, okay? And so what I'm saying is that, like, you can't be afraid to, like, some of the time what holds us back is that what we project out into the world, right? And so if we believe something about ourselves, this is why I'm always so careful. I always am very, very careful, and I tell you guys the same thing, is to be really careful about what you call yourself, right? Because your subconscious is listening, okay? It's listening to what you say. And so, you know, I actually just redid a video just recently on, and you can check out the redone video on how to beat laziness. And I redid the video because in that video I said I'm lazy. And that's no good. It was right in big, bold letters, right? Instead, what I should have said was, in the new video, I said, in the past, I have acted in a way that's lazy. Or I've been lazy. Better even to say I've acted in a way that's lazy, right? Because I'm not identifying with that. I'm not lazy, right? Just because you've done that in the past or acted that way, just because you lack domain knowledge in the past, right, doesn't mean that you do today. Now, I'm starting from here because I think this is the most powerful thing, because you need to understand that what you project into the world, what you tell people about yourself, right, not necessarily verbal, but what you believe about yourself, other people automatically believe about you, okay, if you truly believe it. Now, when you're faking it totally and you're kind of a phony or a fraud and you're trying to represent something that you're not, okay, people detect that as well. But what I'm saying is that if you want to change people's perception of you, change your perception of you. Start there. If you change your perception of you, because think about it, how much information do we have, right? We go and we see all this stuff. We have to take in all this stuff from our eyes, from our ears, right? There's a couple of good books on this. I'm blanking the names now, but they talk about this psychological phenomenon, right? And what it is that we have to essentially take what people tell us or what they appear to be at face value for the most part, because we can't question every aspect of reality. We can't say, I'm not sure if this is, every person, if they're sheep and wolves or wolf in sheep's clothing, right? We can't assume that people are fake, right? We have to assume that they're generally what they're representing. And so if you're representing this, if you keep on having that chip on your shoulder from before, from this one review, thinking that you're position, your reputation is to be really good in technical knowledge, but to lack domain knowledge, other people are going to pick up on it and they're still going to believe that. And when you're giving a talk, right, and you're suggesting an idea, right, perhaps it's not your reputation, but perhaps you already sense that people sense about you that this reputation that you have. And so you're presenting it in such a way that it's sort of conveying this, right? That you're cautious about this, that you're self-conscious about this. And so people are automatically picking up on this and adapting on it because you're leading them in that direction. So what would happen if you changed how you thought about yourself? Let's do something silly. Let's look in the mirror every day and let's say, I have domain knowledge. I'm an expert in domain knowledge. You do it, I won't do it, but you do it, okay? And And just say that about yourself with a big smile on your face. You know, I know this sounds woo-woo and crazy out there, but if you hear that enough times and you tell yourself that, you'll believe it and you'll start acting that way and you'll start projecting that. And again, am I talking about technical skills versus domain knowledge here? No, no. I'm talking about everything, right? This is why, I mean, yes, this is a specific question, but I'll give you a more general answer and say, what area of your life are you being pegged as a round peg in a square hole? What reputation do you have that you think that other people are casting on you, but you're projecting it out to them? Because when you change and you do it boldly and you represent, you know, the new you, people will believe that and they will accept that. It's like I said, you know, I've got a book that I just published a while ago called The Complete Software Developer's Career Guide. Go check it out if you haven't. And there's a chapter on dressing there. And I talk about how, you know, a lot of people ask me questions. They're like, John, I really want to start dressing nice or something. And, you know, because I read the chapter in the book and I talk about the value of that. And they say, but I'm afraid. I'm going to be embarrassed. Like, people are going to think I'm a fraud. They're going to think I'm a phony, blah, 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 all this stuff. And I'm like, look, here's what you do. You just do it. And for a week, people are going to be like, ah, hey, what do you think you are? You think you're like a baller? You got a job interview today, right? Why are you looking so fancy, right? You think you're, you know, whatever. And they're going to rag on you for like a week or like 2 weeks. And then it'll become the new normal, okay? Because you'll just be like, fuck that. I don't care what they're saying. I'm just going to keep on doing what I'm doing, right? And that will become the new normal. And then they'll just see you as that way. You know, most people don't take a big enough step because they don't change how they see themselves. So ultimately, you want to conquer these kind of things, you want to change your reputation, you have to see yourself differently. And then the world is just going to believe whatever you tell the world, whatever you represent in the world. Now, I'll give you one last piece of advice as far as reputation goes, okay? And this is a lesson, again, like him or not, you can learn this from Trump. If your reputation, if you're hiding shit, okay, you've got skeletons in your closet, you can be wrecked. Right? But there's a really good book called Anti-Fragile, okay, which you should read. And it's sort of the strategy of people like Trump, people that it doesn't matter how much bad press they get, it doesn't tarnish their reputation any. And it doesn't mean that you do bad things. And like I said, I don't care if you like him or not. That doesn't matter. Okay. What I'm saying is that, like, one way to protect your reputation is to make sure that you don't have anything that you're really trying to protect. Like, you're being transparent and honest and genuine, right? My reputation, for example, is it's very hard for you to throw paint on me, right? Or to splash mud on me because I'm raw. I'm telling you, like what am I hiding? I got nothing to hide. I'm being transparent and honest, right? So that's another thing to do, is just the more transparency and honesty that you put out there, the less your reputation can people could harm you with your reputation, right? But the more clean and pristine, right? The people who, when you look in the news, who gets the biggest slap down, right? It's priests. It's Catholic priests on molestation charges. Why is this? Is it because Catholic priests are more likely to molest? No, it's probably not. That's probably not the, it's because they're so clean and have such pristine reputations that are so protected that when shit happens, And there's any kind of chink in that armor, it's a big story. It's a big thing. It's a big scandal. You see what I'm saying? Whereas there's other people that, you know, I don't know, like, I've never watched Jersey Shore, but like there's a Snooki character or something on there. I don't think there's anything you could do to tarnish her reputation. You see what I'm saying? I'm not saying that have a bad reputation, but I'm just saying, like, if you're out there, you don't have much to protect. And that's a better way to live your life rather than wondering, hey, is someday someone going to out me and I'm going to be, you know, in big trouble and lose everything I've built. Okay. So that's just my opinion on it. Feel free to leave a comment below and let me know what your opinion is if you got one. And make sure you click the subscribe button, click the bell so you don't miss any videos. I'll talk to you next time. Take care.